cosmic collaboration beyond our wildest dreams. This is a hypothesis presented by a group of inquisitive minds in the scientific field. They claim that our existence on this pale blue dot we call Earth is the work of extraterrestrial civilization. Our extraterrestrial creators may have started us 3.8 billion years ago. What if there are other worlds in the vast, mysterious cosmos that are teeming with intelligent life that surpasses ours in complexity and advancement? This exciting question has occupied countless minds who have pondered the possibility of celestial neighbors predating our world by billions of years. Our own solar system is extremely young, at a tender 4,600,000,000 years old. It looks like a baby compared to the oldest planet we humans have discovered so far. The exoplanet PSR B1620-26b is called by the second name Methuselah, just like the biblical name of one of the ancestors of mankind who lived for 969 years. The planet is a full 12,700,000,000 years old. The famous Francis Crick, Nobel laureate in medicine and revered discoverer of the structure of DNA, even gave his opinion on the fascinating idea of the universe and our origin. Imagine a cosmic ballet in which solar systems much older than ours do pirouettes in the void. In these celestial enclaves may live extraterrestrial civilizations that have surpassed our technological achievements by millennia, and their origins even predate the birth of our home, Earth. The existence of exoplanets in times more ancient than ours, revealed in recent astronomical research, gives reason to consider everything listed here as increasingly possible. Imagine a world where extraterrestrials have orchestrated the great symphony of life on Earth, and the proof of their heavenly handiwork is our own very existence. The mysterious exoplanet PSR B1620, nestled in the constellation Scorpius, is also known among researchers by the nickname the Genesis Planet. This celestial body seems to open a whole portal to the seductive secrets of the cosmos. Could it be that Methuselah harbored alien life long before Earth was formed? Crick offers the scientific community a tantalizing hypothesis that he calls infectious. It suggests that at a distance, advanced civilization may have planted the seeds of primitive life on our humble planet. Intriguing questions also arise from here. How did these extraterrestrial beings bring life to Earth? One answer suggests that they embarked on an interstellar journey aboard a purpose-built ship, a sort of cosmic Noah's Ark, that carry the microorganisms destined to give rise to life on our planet. Most likely, crossing the stars, they had a strict protocol that ensured the preservation of the precious cargo until they reached our planet, which was the final destination of their celestial odyssey. If what we do is important to you, please support us by subscribing to the channel. In 1986, 300 scientists from 22 countries gathered at the Origin of Life conference in Berkeley, California. The mystery of the origin of life on Earth excites their collective intellect. At the time, the prevailing opinion suggested the concept of extraterrestrial origin was implausible, as diverse genetic codes painted a motley picture. Since then, however, rapid advancements in genetics have illuminated a much different picture. From the humblest bacteria to the complexity of humanity, all life on Earth has a common ancestor. Naturally, the burning question remains, where did this primordial cell come from? Many have come to a consensus that the organic progenitors must have come from outer space. Some even venture to propose the hypothesis that a fully formed cell descended from heaven. In 1989, the respected Nobel laureate Manfred Eigen, together with a brilliant team of scientists from the Max Planck Society, achieved the revolutionary success of the sequence, the reverse RNA, which is an integral part of DNA's role in the protein synthesis. Eigen suggests This is how the primordial gene appeared. If the human genetic code can boast an antiquity exceeding 3 billion years, it would stand to reason that it originated from the celestial sphere. For centuries, the scientific community firmly denied the potential existence of life beyond our pale blue dot. However, as a result of remarkable technological advances and new research, scientists are increasingly accepting the possibility that our existence is the work of extraterrestrial beings. If this is so, life on our Earth may be an extraordinary manifestation of a heavenly heritage. Everything said so far may seem quite fantastic, but we still have to admit that we know almost nothing about the sea depths of our own planet and what remains about space and the universe in general. If we are to delve even more seriously into the wilds regarding the hypothesis related to whether ancient extraterrestrial civilizations are responsible for life on our planet and whether they were technologically advanced civilization millions of years before us, then we absolutely must revisit the Silurian hypothesis. It is a thought experiment that assesses the ability of modern science to find evidence of the existence of a previous advanced civilization millions of years ago. The name Silurians is derived from the sentient species of the same name from the BBC science fiction series Doctor Who, whose character in the series created an advanced civilization before humanity. Astrophysicists Adam Frank and Gavin Schmidt purposed the Silurian hypothesis in a 2018 paper exploring the possibility of discovering an advanced civilization in the geological record from before humans appeared. They argue that since the Carboniferous Age, about 350 million years ago, there has been enough fossil carbon to fuel an industrial civilization. However, finding direct evidence such as technological artifacts is unlikely due to the rarity of the fossilization and the exposed surface of the Earth. Instead, researchers can find indirect clues. The hypothesis also suggests that artifacts from past civilizations could be found on the Moon and Mars, where erosion and tectonic activity are less likely to obliterate the evidence. In their 2018 paper, the astrophysicists imagine an advanced civilization that existed long before humans and wonder if it would be possible to find it in the geological record of the Earth. They consider the hypothesis that as early as the Carboniferous Age, there exists such a civilization comparable to ours. However, they also note, although we strongly doubt that any previous industrial civilization existed before ours, asking the question in a formal way which explicitly articulates what the evidence for this might look like raises its own useful questions relevant to both astrobiology and Anthropocene research. According to Frank and Schmidt, since fossilization is relatively rare and only a small part of the exposed Earth's surface predates the Quaternary period, that is, from about 2.5 million years ago, the probability of finding direct evidence of such a civilization is minimal. After much research, questions, and studies, the researchers concluded that modern humans are more likely to find indirect clues, such as rapid changes in the temperature or climate, such as occurred during the Paleocene-Eocene thermal maximum about 55 million years ago, evidence of the use of geothermal energy sources, or anomalies in the sediments, such as their chemical composition, that is, evidence of the use of artificial fertilizers. Isotope ratios can also be looked for and analyzed. For example, there is no natural occurring plutonium-244 outside of a supernova, so evidence of this isotope could indicate a technological advanced civilization. Objects that could be possibly clues include plastics and remnants of nuclear waste buried deep underground or lying deep on the ocean floor. Frank and Schmidt suggest that such a civilization could have traveled through space and left artifacts on other celestial bodies, such as the Moon and Mars. Evidence on these two planets would be easier to detect than on Earth, where erosion and tectonic activity have obliterated much of it. Frank and Schmidt discuss the easiest way to detect traces of a possible extraterrestrial civilization inhabiting the Earth. They then concluded that their potential impact on climate change should have left an imprint in ice cores and tree rings. Both realize that the hypothesis can be extended to Earth and humanity as well, due to the fact that humans have been in their present form for the last 300,000 years and have advanced technology only for the last few centuries. In cosmic background, humanity's sojourn is but a moment. Our industrial civilization is but a heartbeat within this ephemeral existence. If our species disappears into the mists of time, the remnants of our former society will quickly be obliterated. In just a few centuries, the force of rust, decay, and the rhythmic alternations of freezing and thawing will reduce our architectural wonders to ruins. Nature, which has always been stubborn, will reclaim its throne and cover the remains of her metropolises with greenery. She'll reclaim her abode by turning bricks, asphalt, and concrete into dust. Organic matter will decompose and merge with the earth, and the resistant materials will weather and dry out. Glass and ceramics will return to their sandy origins. The steel beams will metamorphose into ore deposits of sorts. Orbital satellites will fall and disintegrate in the atmosphere, and sunken ships will dissolve in the depths of the oceans. In tens of millennia, our once dominant presence will be obliterated. However, measured against the vast cosmetic scale, epochs are mere moments. Our planet Earth has existed for 4.5 billion years, and our sun has at least another 5 billion years left before it turns into a red giant. Imagine a distant epoch about 65 million years from now, when a new intelligent species appears, as distant from us as we are from the dinosaurs. Devoid of any material artifacts, they will have no suspicion of our former civilization, considering the fact that our technologies are becoming more environmental friendly. Our impact on the planet can become difficult to detect. The most sustainable civilization may be the one that leaves no traces behind at all. In the same way, we may not even assume the existence of an intelligent species that disappeared 10 of centuries ago. If what we do is important to you, please support us by leaving a comment and subscribing to the channel.